So when we go to Moldova, we're primarily working with a transitional living home called the Grace House, and that houses about 20 women at a time and for a few years, and prevents basically from them being exposed to the human trafficking industry and gives them a greater opportunity for more education and a life outside of what their society just deems practical.
There was one day we were out, we were getting lunch, and we saw a man yelling at, I presume they were a couple, but he was yelling at her to get in the car, and he got very aggressive with her, and he did actually grab her arm and kind of pull her to the car. And the people there kind of didn't acknowledge it, like it was just a normal everyday thing. And so for us to get to go and tell these girls who've been in a culture like that, who might not feel like they are worth something, you know, for us to get to go in and show them what scripture says and then show that through our actions, and just be able to love on them and tell them that they have a father, even though they might not know their physical father, they have a heavenly father who loves them and wants the best for them, and that life is worth living and that they can have a great life where they, you know, don't have to have that type of abuse.
In Moldova, the orphanage system is very unique because a lot of the orphans that are there actually have parents. Some of them don't, some of them do. And with the ones that do, a lot of the times the parents are out of the picture because they're either drug addicted or they're just honestly financially unable to provide for their children. So for them to go to an orphanage is a better opportunity for the children to be guaranteed a meal at least a day. And so when we go to the orphanages, we go to two different ones. And one is actually in Shushin. It's a structurized building that these kids are staying in and living in. And the other one, a lot of the times what you'll see in Moldova is little villages. And so they'll stay with different little families and have a little community, basically.
Not every need is taken care of at the orphanage. They have minimal food, you know, as much education as they can provide. But now, because the orphanages are dissolving, students, or not students, but children, they do not have a place to go. And so what's happening is that human trafficking is possibly going to increase. It's not going to get better. It's different than what we're used to in America. It's very hard. I have heard from a lot of the girls that it is a very hard life. They have a lot of questions, especially about like, where is God in this time of struggle? Which is like a really deep question. Like, it's so deep, but they are curious, which is a really good starting point. So I think that's a really cool aspect, is that we get to get on that personal level and just like dive into the Bible with them and just show them what, you know, God says about His love.
I think the most important step into getting involved with the Moldova trip, even if they're just thinking about it, is to first, of course, pray on it. And I think that if anyone has a desire to go to Moldova, they should go, because it is life-changing, and it's been one of the most life-changing events that I've ever experienced. Because again, they'll not only gain friends and acquaintances, but they'll gain a lifelong family.